times in a row, that had never been done before. Then again, neither had a 12-inch touchscreen or 1,000 pound-feet of torque. Never been done before. It's just kind of our thing.
All right, scoreless here after the first period. Here's Milan Lucic, and maybe just start with that first period. Obviously, lots of specialty times. What did you see in terms of the interactions with both teams here?
Yeah, you know, as far as our game goes, you know, when we stay out of the penalty box, that's when we give ourselves the best chance to win. And I think our legs were there and our energy was there. We just got to get our head into a little bit more as far as our reads and being smart, and especially on the forecheck, we got to find ways to kill plays and you know, get the puck to stop so we can create some zone time. And if we start doing that, we'll be able to give ourselves a better chance here to sustain some ozone time.
Yeah, did you like, part of that, did you like what you saw then on those 5-on-5 opportunities? You talked about urgency, was there?
Yeah, like I said, I think our legs and our energy are there. Yeah. It's just about sharpening up a little bit. So, yeah, it's just about using all five guys in all three zones. And if we do that, you know, we've shown all year long that we're a really dangerous team.
One last one for you, and that's just the opportunity ahead of you tonight, as we've talked about right there at the Pacific Division, and a victory gets that done. I mean, what does that mean to this group moving forward?
It's huge. You know, we know that they're a desperate team fighting for points right now for a playoff spot, and, you know, we should have the same desperation to win the division here. It's you know, it's a special thing. I know it's a season award, but it's a special thing to win the division, and you put yourself in a home ice advantage type of spot, so lots of motivation as far as that goes.
Appreciate the time.
All right, thank you.
There's Milan Lucic after the first period here.
A way to make Coke Zero Sugar taste better than ever. Don't believe us? Taste it and become a believer. Go on, try it. New Coke Zero Sugar, now more delicious. Best Coke ever? You bet.
Shouldn't he be playing basketball?
Stick to basketball.
Do they even have ice in China?
Women's hockey is just boring, okay?
Once watch girls play.
Go back where we belong. This is where we belong.
It's time to fire it up. Sea of Red. The Calgary Flames have clinched a spot in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Don't miss your chance to witness the exhilarating goals.
And goes in and scores!
Incredible saves.
Stoned by Markstrom!
Experience all the Calgary Flames playoff action live at Scotiabank Saddledome. Sign up now for playoff pre-sales and ticket info. Visit calgaryflames.com/playoffs.
All right, welcome inside Flames TV live at the intermission. It's brought to you by your Alberta Ram dealers, Calgary Flames and Dallas Stars. Scoreless after one, but not for a lack of chances as we take a look at what happened in the first 20 minutes of this hockey game. The Calgary Flames with a victory, of course, would clinch the division title. Obviously, the Dallas Stars fighting for playoff positioning, and a nice save early on there from Jake Ottinger. He was sharp in that first period. A little 4-on-3 action as both teams. I think we had 3 consecutive tripping penalties. This would lead to one of them, a power play opportunity for Rasmus Anderson, who finds the outside of the iron. At the other end, Jacob Markstrom just as sharp. This was the shot by Tyler Seguin. Jamie Benn battling in front. Might have got a stick on it as well. Either way, it's kicked out by Jacob Markstrom. He was good as well on the glove side as John Klingberg walks in on the 2-on-1, flashes the leather there. At the other end, another opportunity, this one from Michael Backlund that finds the top of the crossbar. Not much of an angle there, but a good shot by Backlund nonetheless. It goes off the post and out, and then one last opportunity for the Dallas Stars. It was a flurry in front. Joe Pavelski had the opportunity, but is unable to bury that. Michael Backlund there with a stick as well. But as it stands, scoreless after one, shots even 11-11. And then you see the power play time. Three opportunities for the Dallas Stars, no goals. Calgary Flames have just the one power play opportunity, but plenty of specialty teams time in that first period as well. All right, let's circle back to the last couple of days. A makeup two-game road trip back-to-backs in Chicago and Nashville, and an opportunity for us to go behind the scenes on a road trip recap. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Makes it 3-1 Calgary. Daryl Sutter, of course, played his entire career in Chicago and started his coaching career there.
You're right.
Markstrom shuts him down.
Go Flames, go!
Look at his setup as he works it across to Johnny Gaudreau. From shot, there's a rebound, jammed in. Bonciapane on the power play, and the Flames get back within one. Noah Hanifin, the Flames break out. Here's Backlund going to the goal. There's Toffoli with a puck and a shot. Rebound, they score! Bonciapane ties it up with his second of the game.
We'll go to a shootout.
Playoff type game, down two. Came back, tied it up. That's like a playoff game.